Tickets will be there, people.
Okay, general admission seating 2, which is the cheapest seat, which is $55. General admission 1 is sold out. So now we're at general seating 2. So they've at least got some of the back rows sold out. Can I get ringside? That's where we'd sit, right? Yep. We'd pay for 2 ringside. Yep. Or do we want VIP? No, I guess we'll go for 2 ringside, right? And it's checking the map. They're setting up my map. I got it. And, okay, Andrew, we could actually still get 3rd row.
Not bad.
No. No, not bad at all. In fact, there appear to be quite a few good seats. The more I look at it...
That's not good on their part, but on our fans, that's good for us.
Actually, we could get 2nd row, Andrew. I'm looking at the gray dots, which are the sellouts, and then the seats.
After this,
can't get anything directly around the ring.
You know what, Lee? After this show, there's ticket sales went up. I'm telling you that right now.
No, I usually can do ticket sale pushes for the stuff in Vegas. Now, here's what I don't understand. Roy, why isn't this in downtown Las Vegas? What a great venue.
Yeah.
Roy fighting behind the D on a Saturday night with his own card stacked behind it.
Especially, especially if it's on a big fight weekend. Anybody that's out there, like saying for Chavez Canelo, right? We're just putting that because that's the biggest fight coming up in Vegas here soon. Lee. If 1,000, 2,000 fight fans all of a sudden found out that Roy Jones was fighting up the street on Friday, I think they go and watch that at the right price. I'm just saying.
Yeah, I agree. Whew. There's nothing going on in boxing, really. Okay, go with your last story, Andrew.
Canelo, we'll go back to...
You're going back to Canelo?
Yes.
Going to the Canelo well one more time.
He's basically saying, Lee, that Triple G is getting a final offer in this next round of negotiations.
And I like the fact that he's already concerned with his next fight and not the fight that's in front of him, which
it's going to be like that his whole career, like, though.
Oh, my God, they're selling tickets on Eventbrite. I didn't even know you could sell boxing tickets on Eventbrite. God, I hope he loses just because... It would be awesome.
No, it opens up so many other fights. If Chavez beats Canelo, Canelo won't lose his star power as much as people are trying to put on this fight, actually. And if it's an exciting fight with Mexican fight fans, most of the time, both of your credentials go up. Your star power goes up if you give the fans what they want to see. Barrera Morales being a good example. Vasquez Marquez being another one. So these and Vasquez Marquez, both of the guys really didn't have big fan bases going into that fight. If you see both of them, Morales Barrera wasn't sold out either. Their next two fights are sold out. So Canelo, he would keep his same fans. They would be back to watch him if he was to face Triple G. And then Chavez could rematch Canelo or fight Triple G. So it actually opens up a lot more bigger fights for us if Canelo is to get defeated. If Canelo defeats Chavez Jr., I think everyone kind of throws Chavez Jr. to the side as a kid who was just overrated, got most of his money on his father's name. And then all we're looking at is Triple G versus Canelo again. But Canelo, he needs to stop with the whole, I'm giving him a flat fee. Too many fighters think they're worth more than they are. This dude makes $3 million a fight. Like, seriously, you are not a power mover. You are not a ticket seller in Las Vegas. You might do your thing over in Little Dallas where they don't have shit to do on a Saturday night. But over in Las Vegas, I've been there with Canelo many times where they were giving their tickets away at the end of the night. I believe Christina got in for like $20 one time to go to a Canelo fight. Stop it. He's not Floyd. Lee, if he would have beat Floyd, then everything he's saying about Triple G is true. Triple G would have to basically bow down to him. But you didn't. And not only didn't you not beat Floyd, your opposition since Floyd has went straight backwards. Like, you look like a straight clown giving up your title. Somehow Golden Boy seems to forget that fucking Canelo gave up his title to face Triple G. How that makes him bigger, I just don't understand where it adds up, and maybe De La Hoya is the reason for this. He's not thinking with the straight mind half the time anymore. But it needs to stop. Canelo he really sounds stupid with the whole flat fee thing he's trying to tell his fans. His fans need to be smarter than that. Triple G is an international star. $15 million is not enough for that fight. We're talking a guaranteed purse of $15 million and a backside on the pay-per-view. But to just say that's all you're making, we're going to get 100% of the pay-per-view, you're a joke. You don't want the fight. And for that reason, Teddy, you're a joke too for putting him on your top 10.
Are you dropping the mic on that one?
Yeah, that was actually, the little mouse fell off. Sorry about that.
Yeah, no, it was like I dropped the mic. It was strong. I let you have that one. I like it. Just go to fightnetradio.com. Listen to what you want to listen to. The hashtags at the front of the show will tell you what the show's about. Obviously, you should be smart enough to know, but we have lots of interviews coming up. I'm going to start interviewing some of the guys that are going to appear on the next Roy Jones Jr. card down in Vegas in a couple of weeks. So it'll be nice to interview some boxers again. I've got some MMA people lined up. I've got more BJJ guys. The BJJ thing is hot.
Oh, Lee.
Hot.
Lee. Yeah. Not only did we get the Nacho one right, did you see what fat ass had to move his fight up this week?
No.
Adrian Broner.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we called that one. You know what, Lee? He looked fight. He looked fat at the, remember when he did the Showtime interview?
Yeah, but that's, and here we go back to the antidepressant thing. Like, the amount of antidepressants and anti-crazy shit he's taking is making him fat.
Oh,
and
that happens. True, yeah.
That's true. Bloated. With a lot of antidepressants.
So, yeah, I liked Granados going into this fight. I thought he had what it took to at least give Adrian a run for his money. But my only problem with Granados, and this was at junior welterweight, is that I thought he's fighting out of his weight class like a lot of PBC fighters do. They're all trying to run to those million-dollar fights at the welterweight division. So I thought Granados was out of his weight class. Now that they have him moving, actually going to the welterweights now, come on. This is probably going to be a fight where Granados looks like he's doing good, but just can't hurt the fucking fatter guy, the bigger guy. You know what I'm saying? And Adrian wins late on this fight. But yeah, we called that one too. He looked fat in the fucking press conference he did last week. And then the next day, there it is. They're moving it up 7 pounds.
Yeah, I completely agree. You know Oroville?
Oroville. I've heard of it.
Like Oroville, California?
Yep.
Where we get a lot of our water from?
Yep.
For those who wonder, that don't know much about California and or where areas are, this is all the way up by Yuba City. I guess that would be the closest, biggest city, maybe, I want to say. It's north of Sacramento. It's kind of, it's very east of Andrew, to put it into perspective. But for the first time in 50 years, they had to release water from the lake over the spillway.
Nice.
They're doing it right now. For those of you who don't know, it's kind of a big deal. We kind of have a drought.
Yeah, I want to buy a boat so bad for this summer, Lee.
We got water again.
Yes, we do. It will be nice out there. It's...
Have you tried whipping out the I want a boat, honey?
Oh, yeah. We already went and looked. No. We...
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Wow. All right. Well, that's exciting. You are living the dream.
Yes, sir.
Got your house, got 40 kids. Now you're getting a boat. Kids are going to take
I tell you right now, the Raiders move. That's the first purchase I make. So on March, that vote goes through on a, they give them a green light, Lee. I get a green light on my new boat.
There you go. Anything else?
They raise the ticket prices on us in the Raider games. Don't like that. The almost
my prices are going to go
over
down.
Double.
I'm very excited.
Over, they almost doubled, Lee. Insane.
You know how much it is for a deposit for the Chargers for next year to get me a punch? It's $100 refundable. That is so awesome. I don't even know what to say. Like, I couldn't throw the $100 quick enough
right,
at him.
Right. Hey, and you might, I would say buy extras because you know that Raider game's going to be freaking.
Everybody said that. Everybody I know, they're like, oh, I'm not a Chargers fan, but it's only 30,000 seats. Yeah, that means your teams are going to be up close and personal.
Yeah, those tickets are going to go for some good money if the Raiders are 12-4 again, going to play San Diego.
I won't even go to those games. I'll just sell them.
Yeah, people will be
pay
spending.
For my entire season.
That's a once in a lifetime thing, Lee. With your angle, your pitch about the 30,000 seats, it's almost like the closest people are ever going to be able to get to that game. You know what I mean?
You sat down low. Have you ever sat right on top of the? Isn't it the best?
And
when it's like right there.
And when I think I was there for Rios Alvarado, they actually had a soccer game going on the other. We walked to the other side and watched the soccer game after the boxing match. And yes, it looked. It was one of the best arenas that I had been to. I put it up there because you are up and close in both venues of that place. Right, that's the one where the tennis is on one side and the soccer field's on the other, correct?
Yes. Yeah. No, that was one. That's where we've gone. You've got it correct. You've got it completely correct.
Yeah, we'll be that is interesting. I would buy an extra ticket cuz I bet you some of those games are going to go for at least $500, $600 just because of the lack of tickets, the demand. You know what I'm saying? It's going to be way more than what they have to offer.
Completely. And there you go. That'll do it. Did I miss anything?
No, sir. We got boxing next week, you guys. We'll be talking boxing again next week.
I'm sure we will. And if something amazing happens, we do occasionally record daytime shows. Now, the way to not miss a single show, we haven't quite gotten our Patreon. We're going to have a Patreon site that'll give you an automatic notification of when the shows come out. If you don't know, Perfect Blue Studios produces... I don't know how many shows we produce here, Andrew, like 3 or 4 or 5 or there's a lot of shows. So all you have to do as a Fight Net Radio fan is type in fightnetradio.com and that'll take you directly to the page. But we're getting ready to, I'm going to do a Patreon site, get rid of the advertisers. For those of you that listen to the show regularly, we're going to set it up so you can spend a buck. That's all I'm asking. Spend a buck on the show. Based on the number of people we have listening to the show. Everybody puts in a buck. I don't have to hire advertisers. Andrew and I will get paid for our ridiculousness. And we'll produce lots of quality, stupid content for you. About boxing. And piss off Nacho Bernstein. As much as possible. It seems to be our goal. Go to fightnetradio.com.
I believe in Nacho. I think he puts Chavez over the top, Lee. I'm telling you. As this fight gets closer, I'll be leaning more towards the Chavez last name.
Thank you for enduring another episode of Fight Net Radio. Fight Net Radio is available for download and subscription on iTunes. Or visit Fight Net Radio and tell us how offended you are by today's show. Thank you for listening.